we want to write the system of equations as an augmented matrix and then solve the system by writing the matrix in row echelon form. So the first thing we should recognize is that we have a system of two linear equations with two unknowns. So we'll have a 2x3 augmented matrix. And since the equations are in standard form, meaning the x terms and y terms are on the left, the constants are on the right, we can go ahead and form the augmented matrix. Using the first equation, the first row of our matrix will be 3, negative 1, 7. The second row will be 2, 3, 1. Notice how the first column came from the coefficients of x, the second column from the coefficients of y, and the third column from the constants. Now in most cases we can use this form here for row echelon form, but let's go ahead and review the specifics about row echelon form. We have several examples here below. Notice the first non-zero element in each row, called the leading entry, is 1. Next, each leading entry is in a column to the right of the leading entry in the previous row. And then finally, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. So all these matrices fit these three conditions. Another way to approach this would be to focus on the main diagonal of each augmented matrix, which would mean this diagonal here. Notice in most cases the main diagonal contains ones, but it can also contain a zero. Next, notice that each element below the main diagonal is always zero. If the main diagonal does contain a zero, that indicates the system will either have no solution or infinite solutions. The way we obtain this form of an augmented matrix is using a process called Gaussian elimination, which means any two rows can be interchanged, the elements of any row can be multiplied by a non-zero real number, and any row can be changed by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements with another row. So going back to our example, we want to start by obtaining a zero below the main diagonal, or in this position here. So what we're going to end up doing is obtaining opposites in this first column, and then add the two columns together to obtain the zero. And since the least common multiple of 3 and 2 is 6, let's go ahead and make this element a negative 6 by replacing row 1 with negative 2 times row 1. Let's make this a positive 6 by replacing row 2 with 3 times row 2. So the new row 1 is going to be negative 6, positive 2, and negative 14. The new second row would be 6, 9, and 3. Now we're going to go ahead and replace row 2 with row 1 plus row 2. Now because these elements are opposites, we'll get the zero that we want in this position. So the first row stays the same, and the second row would now be negative 6 plus 6, that's 0, 2 plus 9, that's 11, negative 14 plus 3 is negative 11. Now that we have the zero in the correct position, now we just need to make sure that the first element in each row is positive 1, which means to get a 1 here, we'll multiply row 1 by negative 1 sixth. And to get a 1 here, we'll multiply row 2 by 1 11th. Well, negative 1 sixth times negative 6 is positive 1. That's why we're multiplying by negative 1 sixth. Negative 1 sixth times 2 is negative 2 sixths, or negative 1 third. And negative 1 sixth times negative 14 is positive 14 sixths, or positive 7 thirds. For row 2, we would have 0. Then 1 11th times 11 is 1. 1 11th times negative 11 is negative 1. Now we have our augmented matrix in row echelon form. So now we're going to write this back as a system of equations to solve the system. So using this first row, this is telling us that 1x minus 1 third y must equal 7 thirds, or just x minus 1 third y must equal 7 thirds. The second row is telling us that 0x plus 1y equals negative 1, or y equals negative 1. So now we know the y value of our solution. So we can perform back substitution to find the value of x. So using the first equation, we would have x minus 1/3 times y, which is negative 1, equals 7/3. So we have x plus 1/3 equals 7/3. Subtract 1/3 on both sides. So we have x equals, this would be 6/3 or positive 2. So this is the solution to our system using row echelon form of an augmented matrix. Let's go ahead and write this as an ordered pair, where the x coordinate would be 2 and the y coordinate would be negative 1. If we wanted to verify this solution, we can graph the two lines on the coordinate plane to make sure the two lines do intersect in this point. Let's go ahead and do that. Well, here is the graph of the two lines. Notice how the point of intersection is the point 2, comma, negative 1, verifying our work is correct. Okay, we'll look at a few more examples in the next few videos. I hope you found this explanation helpful.